Hi guys, it's Alex Christian Pigatoto from H428 and welcome to my video. So for today's video, we will cooking or making three Mexican dishes or Mexican cuisine, which is for our appetizer or snacks, we will making tacos. For our starch, we will making arroz rojo or Mexican red rice. And for our protein or main dish, we will making shrimp fajitas.
Mexican cuisine consists of the cooking cuisines and traditions of the modern country of Mexico. Mexican food is popular because it's full of flavor. The Mexican dishes include healthy and fresh ingredients just like avocados, beans, chiles, and different types of meat like beef, chicken, pork, fish, and lamb, among others used in tacos, tamales, or soup.
For our first dish, let's go and make our appetizer, which is the tacos or Mexican tacos.
Taco or tacos is a traditional Mexican dish consisting of a small hand-sized corn or wheat tortilla topped with a filling. The tortilla is then folded around the filling and eaten by hand. But first, let's do first our taco salsa. And here's the ingredients. 2-3 medium fresh tomatoes, stem removed and cut into small cubes. Then 1/2 medium red onions cut into small cubes, 2 serrano or 1 jalapeno peppers, stem, ribs and seeds removed. Then 1-2 lemon or lime juice, 1/2 cup chopped cilantro, salt and pepper to taste, 1 pinch of dried oregano, and 1 pinch of ground cumin. But remember to adjust it to your liking. And now, let's go and make our salsa for our tacos. For this recipe, we will mix all the ingredients by using spoon. But if you have a food processor who can finely chop the ingredients, you can use it to make your life easier. For this recipe, the first step, in an empty bowl, mix all the ingredients such as tomatoes, red onions, jalapeno peppers, lime or lemon juice, your chopped up cilantro, and lastly the seasoning like cumin and dried oregano. For the salt and pepper, add it at the last part and taste if the taste gets what you like and adjust if it's not. If the salsa is too hot because of the chilies, add some more of tomato. But if it's not, you can put some cumin and the chili seed you remove from your chilies. Then once it's done, let the salsa sit for an hour under room temperature or chill for the flavors to combine. Except for a taco, you can serve this salsa with chips, tortillas, burritos, tostada, quesadilla, or pinto or black beans. And this salsa can be refrigerated up to 5 days. And for our meat and our tacos, here's the ingredients. 1/2 kilo or 500 grams of ground beef, 1/2 medium onion, you can use white but it's chopped, 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 tablespoon of taco seasoning, and salt and pepper to taste. And remember that always adjust the seasoning based on your liking. Now, let's cook our meat for our tacos. First, heat the skillet or pan over medium high heat. Then, drizzle some oil until you reach the 320 degrees Fahrenheit temperature. Or if you don't have the thermometer, you can stick a slice of onion and once it starts bubbling, you can now saute it. Once the onion achieves the translucent looks, you can now put your beef and brown it for at least 5 to 10 minutes and stir in continuously to avoid burn. You can lower your heat if you think that your beef is going to burn. The next step, and lastly, season our beef with taco seasoning or a combination of chili powder, garlic powder, onion powder, red pepper flakes, oregano, paprika, cumin, salt, and pepper. And I added a little bit or 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder to achieve a hot taste, which is the symbolism of Mexican food. Then taste it if it's okay and adjust by putting salt and pepper if it's not. For a honest review, for me, the taste is good. And now, let's set it aside. For assembling our tacos, here's the ingredients. Our taco shell, I use hard shell but you can use soap tortilla bread. So, next is our lettuce, our shredded cheese, and don't forget our salsa that we made earlier, and lastly our cooked beef, which also what we cooked earlier. For our final step or final procedure, let's now assemble our tacos. First, put the beef we cooked earlier into a taco shell. You can use tortilla soft as your base if you can find taco hard shell. Then next step is top it with the salsa we make, and then put the lettuce and lastly the cheese. Remember that don't overcrowd all the fillings or toppings that we put in our taco shell. And remember to hold the taco shell with a care because it can easily be break or tear apart. Then repeat the process until all your ingredients has been used. And voila! You can now serve and enjoy your Mexican tacos. For most people, any time of day is the right time of a day to eat tacos. But there is actually a specific taco time. According to Mexican tradition, seafood tacos are meant to be eaten at lunch, while antojitos are to be eaten at dinner time.
Let's move on and let's cook or make our second dish, which is our starch or our Mexican red rice or arroz rojo.
Arroz rojo or Spanish rice is also known as a Mexican rice or red rice. It is a Mexican starch with the ingredients of other dishes made from white rice, tomatoes, garlic, and onions. It is traditionally made by sauteing the rice in a skillet with oil or fat until it is colored golden brown. And here's the ingredients. 1 tablespoon of olive oil, or you can use any type of oil. 2 cloves garlic, minced. 1 onion, diced. 1 1/2 cup basmati rice, but I use a regular rice. So expect that we need to put a lot of broth or water for our rice. Then next is 1 can of tomato sauce, or 8 ounces of tomato sauce. 1 1/2 cup of vegetable broth, or you can substitute chicken broth. 1 cup of corn kernels. 1 1/2 cup of diced carrots. 1 1/2 cup of frozen peas, 1/4 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of cumin, salt and pepper to taste, 2 tomatoes diced, and lastly, it is optional, 2 tablespoons of chopped fresh parsley. Now, let's cook our starch dish or our Mexican red rice. First, heat a large skillet or heavy bottom pan in a medium heat. Then saute our onion first when the oil starts bubbling but doesn't reach the smoking point temperature. For this recipe, I saute first the onion because garlic can easily burn compared to onions. Then stir frequently for at least 2 to 3 minutes until it becomes translucent. Daily reminder, as you can notice, I did not put my hat or cap because I misplaced it and I can't find it. But remember to use a headband or a hairnet when cooking to avoid hair fall in our food and to avoid food poisoning or food contamination came from our hair. Then next, after sauteing our onion and garlic, toss now our rice until toasted for at least 2 minutes. Then stir in the tomato sauce and our broth and bring to a simmer for at least 3 minutes. Then mix or stir so that it can combine and the taste is equally divided into our rice. Once our starch starts simmering, you can now stir in the carrots, peas, corn, chili powder, tomato, and cumin to taste. But if you are using frozen vegetables, you can put it earlier before simmering. And mix until combined and the bottom of the pan not get burned. Then cover it and wait for it to boil. Once it starts boiling, cover it and reduce the heat and simmer until rice is cooked through about 13 to 16 minutes if you are using basmati rice. But since I am using a regular rice, it will take up for at least 30 minutes. So if your sauce or broth has been dried up, put a little bit of broth or water until you achieve the consistency or texture of a cooked rice. Then serve immediately, garnish with chopped parsley or cilantro if desired. Then don't forget to adjust the taste based on what you like. I'm not contented in the color of our rice because it's not rojo or red, more on orange yellowish. But for the taste, I really really like it. Always remember to taste your dish because you can adjust it before serving it to your customer or guest. And voila! This dish is best to take while it's hot and at its best. Partner it with your favorite protein dish that you like.
For our protein or our main course, let's go and make our final dish, which is the shrimp fajitas.
These shrimp fajitas are tender Mexican seasoned shrimp cooked in a skillet with plenty of peppers and onions. Also, shrimp fajitas are easy, flavorful one pan meal in Mexico or Mexico. 250 grams or 300 grams of large shrimp peeled and deveined. Tails remove if desired, but for this recipe, I'm not remove the tail for additional appearance. Then, 1 half teaspoon of ground cumin, 2 tablespoon chili powder, 1 4 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 4 teaspoon onion powder, 1 half teaspoon paprika, 2 tablespoon chopped fresh parsley. Then, 1 tablespoon vegetable oil, 2 cups sliced bell pepper, red, orange color, but you can add yellow or a combination of both three. Then 1 onion thinly sliced, lemon wedges for serving or garnishing, then salt and pepper to taste. Let's now cook our shrimp fajitas. First, heat our pan over high heat for a second, then drizzle the oil. Then spread your oil all over your pan just like this so that once we put our vegetable, it can cook equally. If you are using a non-stick pan, less oil is enough to caramelize and saute our vegetable. Once you achieve the perfect temperature for sauteing, which is approximately around 320 degrees Fahrenheit, you can now saute the bell pepper and onions. Then stir occasionally for a couple of minutes or until the vegetables are tender and charred on the edges. While sauteing in a small bowl or plate, mix all the fajitas seasoning, which is the chili powder, cumin, garlic powder, onion powder, paprika, then set it aside. Next, sear or cook the shrimp in a pan with onion and bell pepper for a couple of minutes before we will season it with our fajita seasoning and stir to combine. And lastly, sprinkle some salt and pepper. Then cook for 4 to 5 minutes or until the shrimp achieve pink or opaque color. Before plating it, taste test first your food if it's too salty or bland, but if you achieve the taste that you like, you can now serve it. For the plating and garnish, you can chop parsley on top or cilantro if you have one at home. Then place your lemon if you desire your dish to have a yellowish palette on your plate. And voila! You can now enjoy and eat your shrimp fajitas while at its best, partnered with your rice, or you can top it in your tortilla bread.
Thank you for watching my video. I hope you learned a lot from me, and I encourage you to do and make all the dishes that I made because it's very delicious. Thank you and goodbye.